In the previous section, we studied about NumPy and arrays. In this section, we are going to study how to manipulate a data frame using the Pandas library. Pandas is an open-source library which is used in data preparation, manipulation, modeling, and analysis. In this video, we will work on a downloaded data set to do the following. Prepare data by deleting other columns to retain only OHLC prices. Handle missing data. Analyze data by finding statistical properties such as rolling mean. Plot simple moving average. Select specific cells within the data. Discuss other benefits of using Pandas. All these topics and more are discussed in IPython notebook, along with Python codes. Let us begin by loading an OHLC data frame of an Indian stock called Infosys using the pd.read_csv function. This is how the data frame looks like. This Infy data frame has 497 rows and 13 columns. To retain only OHLC price columns in this data frame, we will use the dataframe.drop function along the axis equals 1. The new data frame called Infy_new has only 5 columns now. This is called manipulation of a data frame that is forming a time series of data that we actually need and not what is provided. It is possible that financial data we have downloaded may have missing values in it. These missing values are called as NaN or not a number values. These missing numbers need to be filled so that we can perform column-wise functions. One of the ways to do that is by using fillNA function available in Pandas. Here, the method which we have used to fill the NaN values is ffill, or forward fill. Ffill takes the value of the previous cell within the column and fills the cell with it. Further, one can run functions on a chosen column of the dataset. Say you want to find the rolling mean of the closing prices of Infosys stock. This can be achieved by a single line of code. Here we have taken Infy data frame and call the rolling function with parameter as window equals 20, and then calculate mean using the mean function. This is the output. Can you guess why the initial 19 rows have the value NaN? It is because the rolling average window is 20, and it would require 20 values to compute the first average. This output is better represented on graphs. To plot, you must have a good hand on Matplotlib. In the upcoming notebooks, apart from basic functionalities and applying statistical functions to a data frame, we will also learn indexing and grouping data from a data frame. Indexing in Pandas is similar to NumPy indexing that helps us in selecting specific data values. Here, it is done using the iloc function. You may look at the following example. If this is the entire data frame, and we just want to select the first 5 rows, and only the open, high, low, last price, and close columns, the code would be as follows. Grouping helps us to understand data in a systematic way. For example, assume this is a representation of your portfolio. If you group your investments by sector, then this is how you do that using Pandas. Now, you can clearly see the shares of different sectors within the portfolio. These topics and more would be covered in the IPython notebooks covered in this section. The notebooks are as follows. Series. Data frame and basic functionality. Descriptive statistical functions. Indexing, reindexing, and missing values. We start with a basic data structure called series, as they are similar to NumPy arrays discussed in previous section. Also, they are a type of data frame. Find out more in the next unit.